come join me as I am waking up with the sun. There is a sunrise every single day and it's gorgeous to see and absolutely free and one of the best beautiful experience I have here.
This is 5:45 in the morning and I'm right now in the rooftop of my hotel and this view is amazing. You can understand from my voice that is shocking. All of this chilly and windy weather. Let me show you this beautiful sunrise.
When the sun is low above the horizon, sunlight rays must penetrate the atmosphere for a greater distance, reducing the intensity of the direct light so that more of the illumination comes from indirect light from the sky, and it's called golden rays or golden hour of the time. And this period of daytime shortly after sunrise and before sunset is really bright, beautiful. This golden hour is also sometimes called the magic hour, especially by the cinematographers. During this time, the brightness of the sky matches the brightness of street lights, car headlights, and lit windows. This hour actually lasts about 20 to 30 minutes. Four of the highest peaks in the world, Everest, Kanchenjunga, Lhotse, Makalu, can be seen from its summit. It's also affords a pristine view of the entire Kanchenjunga range. The name Kan means head, Chin means belly, and Jungha means knee. So if you can clearly view these three tops at same time, you could see that Buddha is sleeping. That's why this hill also known as Sleeping Buddha.
Hey, the sunrise is complete and I'm in front of this. I don't have any words to say and I am all teared. Signing off for the day. Please subscribe my channel. Do like, comment and share.
The ascent to Sandakfu is amazing and full of picturesque sights. The sights become even better in the morning. For me, it seems a best place to be on the planet Earth, and sometimes it's worth not pushing that snooze button.
Today is day 3 from my Sandakfu tour and right now we are in front of Chitre Monastery. Today's weather is a bit foggy and there is no one. Due to COVID restriction, camera and videography is prohibited inside the monastery, but this location is really beautiful. Chitre is almost 5 km from Manabhanjan and it's almost the last entry point of and the scenic beauty is really nice.
Chitre Monastery is on the way to Sandakfu from Manabhanjan. As you are driving afield, it's a beautiful place to stop, admire the breathtaking views, breathe deeply the fresh air and admire the old pine trees swaying in the wind. Chitri Monastery is one of the oldest monasteries in Darjeeling district. It is situated at a height of around 8,000 feet and today is a bit cloudy, otherwise complete range of almighty Kanchenjunga ridge can be visible. Nothing ever becomes real till it is experienced. On every journey, we experience different culture, diversity of beautiful places. And this is the last part from my Sandakfu series, and it almost costs to you 10,000 if you plan it wise on nice way. Now I am signing off. Goodbye. We'll be back with my next adventure soon. Please do like, comment and share. Please let me know if you have any questions in comment sections below. Till then, thank you for watching. Ta-da!